morning, everyone. So I've taken the liberty to deviate a little bit from the topic given to me. So I'm going to now be focusing only on coal energy with a special focus on health. So I'm going to start off with a little bit of context setting into Tamil Nadu's coal energy sector. Tamil Nadu is a coastal state with about 1,076 kilometers of coastline. And primarily due to the availability of space as well as access to seawater, a lot of water-intensive industries, especially coal, has been set up on the coast. So we have three major coal clusters that operate at this point of time. So one is the North Chennai Industrial Cluster in Ennore, and then we have the Neyveli Cuddalore sector in central Tamil Nadu, which also has highly dense coal cluster, and then is the Thoothukudi cluster in the south. And apart from this, a lot of coal industries as well as port-based coal industries have been proposed along the coastline. This is being pushed further with the current government's Sagarmala scheme, which is primarily a port-based development scheme. And a lot of coastal economic zones have been proposed, wherein a lot of investment is proposed to be pumped into developing port infrastructure that will further drive polluting industries like coal on the coast. And I'm saying this because most of the proposed coastal economic zones in Tamil Nadu are in areas where already existing coal industries are present. So we have the Ennore, Kattupalli, North Chennai Coastal Economic Zone, and then we have the Karaikal Coastal Economic Zone and the Thoothukudi Coastal Economic Zone in the south. But there's also another very important stakeholder in the coast, which is the fisher folk. And Tamil Nadu, being a coastal state, has almost 10 lakh fishers, marine fishers from about 600 fishing villages that also use the coastal commons as well as the nearshore waters for their livelihoods. And this is leading to sort of a tussle between large industries and fisher folk on the coast, primarily due to large scale land use change. And land contamination, wherein coastal areas and coastal commons that are presently being used by these communities are often taken away and converted into industrial real estate. And we also have both air and water pollution that poses to be a great risk for coastal communities. So the impacts of our coal choices are twofold. When we talk about health, I think what is mostly being done is that it's being restricted to the arena of human health. But large industries also pose a big risk to the ecological health of these areas. Primarily, this sort of large-scale land use changes that leads to polluting entire landscapes that then sort of reduces the ecological productivity of these areas, and thereby affecting both mental health as well as physical health of the populations dependent on these landscapes for their livelihoods. So, low pollution and low ecological productivity often pushes coastal communities who are dependent on these landscapes to high levels of stress, anxiety, and depression. And the pollution from these industries can also cause respiratory, cardiovascular, neurological, and other forms of physical health risks. So, to demonstrate all of this, I'm going to take you to Ennore, which is regarded as Chennai's sacrifice zone. So for Chennai city to sort of grow and maintain its metropolitan, cosmopolitan image, the northern area of the city, which is the Ennore Creek, has been has been sacrificed for the city's growth. So just to give you an idea as to what the Ennore Creek is, It is a coastal estuarine area with a large 8,000 acre backwater that is dotted with mangroves and salt pans, and it sort of supported a very vibrant farming, fishing, salt farming economy. It's also very hydrologically and ecologically important to Chennai because it drains two large rivers, the Kosasaraya River in the south and the Aranya River in the north. Thereby, the basin that it forms, the AK Basin, is a very important water source for Chennai City. This area also supports a large agrarian ecosystem, sorry, agrarian economy, and a very important fishing economy in the state. But today, the Ennore Creek and Ennore area has sort of been converted to become Tamil Nadu's coal hub. So about 1,000 acres or more of the backwaters have now been converted into coal-fired thermal power plants and other coal infrastructure. And so in a radius of about 2 kilometers, there are almost 3,500 megawatts of installed coal capacity. There are about double that amount, another 3,500 megawatts is currently in the post-permit and construction stage. That will take this area to about 7,000 megawatts in the next couple of years. There is also a 10 million tons per annum coal handling capacity coal yard that is primarily catered to by two ports in the area. So there is the Adani LNG Kattupalli port and the Kamarajar port, which both sort of handles coal for the coal yards in the area. And this Ennore has a much larger footprint because it's not only Ennore that these things cater to. So there is a big network of a very extensive road and rail network connecting large parts of the hinterland to Ennore that sort of extends its coal footprint from just this area. So there is the Bangalore-Chennai Industrial Corridor, there is the Chennai-Vishakhapatnam Industrial Corridor, the Chennai Peripheral Road that connects to the Salem-Chennai Expressway. So the idea is to locate as many polluting industries as possible, as many coal industries as possible in Ennore so that it can cater to the Tamil hinterland. But this has pushed the Ennore Creek into a massive ecological health crisis because a large amount of these power plants and coal yards and ash ponds have been built within the backwater system of the river. And this is a picture of a fisherman holding up sediment from the river. And we can see that the river bed has been completely replaced with fly ash from pipelines that leak throughout the day, all through the year, thereby silting up about 20 kilometers of the river. And this has led to massive decline in the quality as well as quantity of fish caught in this river. So that is a picture of ash-laced fish and prawn and crabs that have been caught from this river. And because the most famous sort of seafood that is being caught in this area is prawns and crabs, which are bottom-dwelling species. And these species now literally grow in ash and thereby sort of are heavily contaminated. And Ennore being a polluted industrial cluster is sort of well known. And so there is really no commercial value for the fish or the prawns that are being caught in this area. Another big challenge is the continuous shrinking of the river itself. So backwaters are constantly being reclaimed and built upon. And so as the river shrinks, so does the health as well as the livelihoods of the people who are dependent on this river. So in 2017, a respondent to a case filed by the fisher folk challenging and asking for remediation or like cleanup of fly ash in the river, the National Green Tribunal set up an expert committee to look into the quality of the river and what sort of contamination exists. And it was found that Both shellfish, prawn, and fish caught in this river had extremely high levels of lead and cadmium, which are both very harmful to human health because it can cause a large number of exposure can cause a large number of problems, right, from nerve damage to cancer. And with regards to lead, there really is no safe limit to exposure to lead. And because of the drop in commercial value, there really is no market for these fishers to sell their goods. And so, but three fishing villages that are dependent on this river for fishing often use the fish caught in the river for local consumption, again hurting the locals who live in this area. So I'm going to take you to Sepakam, which is a village located, a very small village located now next to what is now 1,500 acre ash pond of 1,800 megawatt North Chennai Thermal Power Station. This village used to be a very beautiful agrarian salt farming village, and so people over here used to grow paddy on the western side and farm salt on the salt pans. Today these salt pans have been taken over for the construction of this ash pond, thereby sort of converting this area into a very dystopian, dusty, completely non-livable area. And so if you can see pictures on the other side, houses have been flooded with ash slurry that from leaky pipelines that carry the ash slurry from the power plant to the ash pond, forcing people to vacate and leave. And so right now if you go to Sepakam, there are really no trees, really no public infrastructure, just a couple of houses with people from 60 households who have no social or economic mobility to be able to leave. So as many people as possible who can leave the village have already left, leaving the people who live in this village to literally live in ash. And so a community-based phenomenological study, which is basically the study of phenomena that cause other results, was carried out in Sepakam. And it was found that most residents face very severe respiratory as well as skin illnesses. And the complete absence of any sort of basic healthcare or drinking water facilities or public transportation have pushed people over here to really not prioritize their health at all. So it's only when it's extremely serious do they even go to the doctor or even try to access any sort of healthcare facilities. And so, quoting from a respondent from the village, they said that it is not possible to dry any clothes outside or even let vessels that have been washed outside the house because it just gets covered in ash. So people try to stay home and not go out as much as they can. Another area is Kurvi Medu that I'd like to present here. Kurvi Medu translates into the Sparrow Hill and used to once be one of the highest points in this area, surrounded by salt pans and the river, which is now, because of the advent of coal industries in Ennore, the salt economy or the salt farming economy in Ennore has totally collapsed, thereby getting the government to sell a lot of these salt pan lands, intertidal salt pan lands, to other companies for setting up infrastructure. So the 1,500 megawatt NTPC Valur Thermal Power Station has been built very close in the salt pan lands next to Kurvi Medu, and Kurvi Medu now has been buried between the power plant and the ash pond. So no more sparrows and there are no more a hill. And this village has extremely high levels of air pollution, thereby leading their quality there to be very, very unhealthy. And so that's a picture of a woman rubbing her fingers by a photo that was hanging on her wall. And you can see her hand and there was so much dust in the area. And so responding to requests from the community to carry out some sort of health camp, Huma Lung Foundation and Community Environmental Monitoring conducted a health study or a health camp in Kurvimedu, and it was found that a lot of people in Kurvimedu exhibited very similar sort of health effects, and so and a lot of dry cough that was accompanied without any phlegm, that sort of indicated that there was no pathogen infection but rather physical irritants that caused this sort of a health issue. And because of a large number of people having similar health concerns, it was concluded that Kurvimedu is a site of public health concern. The third and final site I would like to talk about is Minjur. Minjur was once an agrarian village located close to the Ennore backwater. Now it is located close to the Ennore industrial cluster and is basically just a collateral damage for Ennore's growth. So Ennore grew and now supports the Sipcot, Gumlipundi, the industrial estate, where there are about 36 captive thermal power plants in one industrial estate. And so a large Tiruvallur highway now runs through the middle of the Minjur village through the bazaar area, catering with heavy vehicles carrying coal and ash from Minjur to Gumlipundi and otherwise. And because of the decline in the coastal buffers, the salt, the groundwater in Minjur has completely become salinized, forcing people to abandon agriculture as a primary source of livelihood. So now people have little shops and other things, little other businesses in the main bazaar area to survive. And we see that because of the transportation cost, the transportation of coal and ash from Minjur to from Ennore to Gumlipundi, a lot of these small shack owners who have no other way but to stay in the bazaar and sell their wares are often the most impacted. So there has been a primary health assessment conducted in Minjur, where it was found that the street vendors in the bazaar area are the main sort of receptors of these the pollution load, and respiratory and skin allergies were again reported from this area. So how can we say that fossil fuels and coal-based industries was the cause of health decline in Ennore and nearby areas? And so to sort of do a comparison, we conducted a baseline health study in Cheyyur, which is the site of the 4000 megawatt ultra-mega thermal power plant that's been proposed in the area. And Ennore and Cheyyur have very similar demographic, very similar economies, because of fishing farming economy. And so in 13 villages, about 266 people were surveyed. And it was found that people in Cheyyur are far more healthy than the people in Ennore, meaning only 1% of the population in Cheyyur reported any sort of chronic illnesses that they've experienced in the last 1 year, compared to more than 15% in Ennore. And the only difference between Ennore and Cheyyur is that Cheyyur does not have any polluting industries yet. And so with some amount of certainty, we're able to say that it was the advent of polluting industries like coal in Cheyyur that sort of accelerated the health decline in the area. And so to conclude, we know that all of us know that coal has coal power, usage of coal has large climate effects. But what is often not being spoken about or often being ignored is the local effects that coal industries could have. And so when industries like this come up in areas like Ennore, the entire local landscape transforms and sort of also undoes the natural climate resilience that landscapes like this provide. So now in Ennore, the hydrology is completely sort of neglected while construction of these industries. And so every time it rains, a small rain event becomes a flood event. Salinity intrusion is at an all-time high. Agrarian economies are collapsing. Fishing economies are collapsing, and there is really no resilience to any sort of climate event anymore. And also the erasure of local economies and the sort of livelihood costs that are externalized is a huge problem, because companies come and sort of destroy entire livelihoods that take away lakhs of jobs and then provide one job per household, which is, you know, 200 households, 200 jobs per village, which is completely externalizing livelihood costs. And health costs are almost invisible. There is really no state or company companies that provide any sort of health insurance or even takes care of or even sort of accepts that there is a health there is a health emergency in the area. And so, to conclude, we're saying that coal industries have only impoverished local communities and not developed this area in any way. And has only pushed the communities to becoming more vulnerable to both climate as well as health as well as financial risks.